This is part 6 of a series on XGBoost. In this video, we will implement the XGBoost classification in code from scratch. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English, and my voice was generated through AI, text-to-speech. In the last video, we analyzed the exact greedy algorithm for split finding presented in the section 2.1 of the paper and applied this to XGBoost classification. In this video, we'll implement this algorithm in code from scratch. This code may be a bit difficult for machine learning beginners. Beginners are recommended to skip this video and move on to the next video. Since GBM classification uses decision trees constructed from the CART algorithm, we were able to implement GBM from scratch using the decision tree regressor. In the CART algorithm, the optimal split point was found using the gain obtained from the Gini index or entropy. However, rather than using the typical CART algorithm, XGBoost classification uses regularization and pruning, uses scores and gains to split nodes, and computes output values to predict the next target class. Therefore, the decision tree regressor cannot be used for XGBoost classification. Therefore, if you want to implement XGBoost from scratch, you first need to implement a base learner. That's why this code may seem a bit difficult. To understand this code, you must first understand the exact greedy algorithm for split finding from the previous video, as well as the code for creating a binary tree using recursion covered in this decision trees video. This code is an upgraded version of the code covered in this video. Here we will only discuss the changes in XGBoost. First, create a MyXG classification tree class to use as the base learner for XGBoost. Set the tree's depth, regularization constant, and pruning constant. We use feature data and residuals as the training data, and use the y-hat value from the previous iteration round. In the first round, this is an initial prediction. Now let's implement the algorithm 1, exact greedy algorithm for split finding, presented in the paper we looked at in the previous video. This algorithm can be easily implemented using the XGBoost library, but to understand more about how it works, let's implement it from scratch. And let's compare this with the results from the XGBoost library. G is a negative residual. The uppercase G is the sum of the negative residuals within a node. And in classification, H is calculated using this formula. And the similarity score is calculated using this formula. Here, the lambda is a regularization constant. Now let's implement the above algorithm in code. First, let's write the node split function. This function splits the parent node into left and right child nodes. This function is a modified version of the node split function used in this video. R is the lambda, which is a regularization constant. And D is the number of features. Next, we calculate G and H for the parent node before splitting. Uppercase G is the sum of the negative residuals. Since we will be squaring G later, we calculated it here as the sum of the positive residuals. And the uppercase H is the sum of these formulas above. Where DID is the data points number. For example, the parent node has the data points 1, 3, and 4. We then use this formula to calculate the score of the parent node. This is the similarity score of the parent node before splitting. If there are multiple features X, read these feature vectors one by one. The algorithm on the left uses two for loops. The 4K loop reads the feature vectors one by one, and the 4J loop reads the split point candidates in the feature vector one by one. First, initialize GL and HL of the left node to be split to zero. And then read the kth feature vector. This is the xfeet variable, and split the xfeet into left and right nodes. Here, we remove duplicates of xfeet and sort them in ascending order. This is the xunique variable. Let's draw the xunique variable like this. The single cell can contain multiple identical pieces of data. These intermediate values then become the split point candidates. This is the S point variable. Now read the split point candidates one by one and use these points to split the X feet into left and right nodes. Data points with X feet less than J are assigned to the left node, and data points with X feet greater than J are assigned to the right node. Then calculate the GL and the HL for the left node using the formula above. The GL is the sum of the residuals contained in the left node, and the HL is the value calculated with this formula. If J is this point and J minus 1 is this point, then the parent node will be split into left and right nodes at the point J. The GL of the previous step is this part, and this part is accumulated. The same goes for the HL, and the GR and HR for the right node are the G and H of the parent node minus the GL and HL of the left node. Then we use this formula from the algorithm on the left to calculate the gain, where p-score is the parent similarity score calculated on the left. And as we iterate, we find the maximum value of this gain. If the gain calculated above is greater than the max gain, set the K of this iteration as the best feature ID, and the J as the best split point. After iterating over all features and all split point candidates, the pruning constant is used to decide whether to split the parent node. If the max gain is greater than the pruning constant, gamma, use the best split point to split the parent node into left and right nodes. Otherwise, the parent node will not be split. Up to this point, it is a function that splits the parent node into left and right nodes. Now we continue to split the child nodes using recursion. We call the node split function recursively to continue splitting the child nodes. Recursion is used here. The recursive split is a function that creates a binary tree using recursion. This function is identical to the code seen in this decision tree video. Please refer to this video for more information about recursion. Now let's write a function to calculate the output value of the leaf node. The output value is calculated using this formula. The numerator is the sum of the negative residuals, and the denominator is the value calculated using this formula plus a regularization constant. This is the output values for each leaf node. The following function finds all leaf nodes in the tree and calculates the output value of each leaf node. In this function, recursion is also used to find all leaf nodes. This function is also identical to the code in this decision tree video. Now we will use these functions to create the decision tree. X is the feature data and Y is the residual data. And we start with the predicted value from the previous round. Initially, we split the root node using the node split function. This code is also the same as the code in this video. Next, let's write a function to predict the output value of the test data. Find the leaf node in the tree P to which this test data point X belongs, and return the output value of that leaf node. This is the same as the code in this video. Finally, we will write a function that predicts the output values for the entire test data. This function is also the same as the code in this video. So far, we have created a base learner for XGBoost classification. Now use this base learner to implement the XGBoost classification. Since the residuals are learned, a regression tree is also used for classification. The class name is MyXClassifier. Set the total number of trees and the depth of each tree. And set the learning rate, pruning constant, and regularization constant, etc. Then, write a function that converts log odds into probability. This is the logistic function. Now create a fitting function. X is the feature data, and Y is the target class of the training data. Here Y is not residuals. This part is the same as the code that implements the GBM classification in this video. XGBoost only changes the internal structure of the base learner, so the boosting algorithm is the same as GBM. Step 1 initializes the predictions. The base score is the initial prediction, Y hat 0. The F0 is the initial log odds value. And the FM is the log odds value of the previous round. And the Y hat is the probability converted from the log odds FM. Step A and step 2 calculates the residuals. In step B, we will create a base learner model using the MIXGBC classification tree class created on the previous page. We then fit the base learner to the feature data and residuals, and predict the output values of the training data, where the gamma is the output value. Here it is not a pruning constant. We then use these output values to update the log odds FM from the previous iteration round. And we predict the new Y using the updated log odds. Save this model and calculate the loss. The loss is binary cross entropy. And write the predict function that predicts the target class of the test data. This function is also identical to the code in GBM. Now let's use the MyXGBC classifier class to implement XGBoost classification. the data we will use is like this. And we visually check the training data, test data, and the predicted target classes. We set the initial prediction to 0.5. The depth of each tree is set to 3, and the number of trees is set to 20. And the learning rate, eta, is set to 0.3. The regularization and the pruning constant are set to 0.1 and 0.01, respectively. We now create a MyXGB classifier model and fit this model to the training data. If you look at the loss history, it's like this. As the iteration progresses, you can see that the loss measured by the binary cross entropy decreases significantly. Then, we randomly generate test data and predict the target class of the test data. When we visualize the prediction results, we get the following results. Yellow dots are training data, and blue and red are test data. The blue dots are the areas where Y is predicted to be 0, and the red areas are the areas where Y is predicted to be 1. The decision boundary looks like this. This time we will use the XGBoost library. Use this library to create a model and fit this model to the training data. And predict the target class of the test data. If you check this result with the naked eye, it looks like this. In this case, the decision boundary came out like this. You can see that the two results are similar. In this way, using the XGBoost library, you can easily implement the XGBoost classification. Let's run this code. We can see that the loss continues to decrease and the results of our own implementation match well with those of the XGBoost library. Let's run it one more time. This time, the results came out like this. The multi-class classification of XGBoost is the same as the GBM. Please refer to the GBM video for this part. So far, we have implemented the XGBoost classification algorithm from scratch. In the next video, we will look at the approximation algorithm and implement the algorithm in code.